The base is going to be 3/4 inch MDF, and I need to cut it down to 12 inches by 14 inches. I'm also going to cut out the fences. These are going to measure 12 inches long by 2 inches wide. That piece of 1/4 inch plywood that I cut down is going to be used as a template for the drilling, as well as for the routing. I marked 1 inch in from one end and 4 inches in from the other and made a tick mark that is centered inside each strip. And I'm going to drill these out with a 1/4 inch drill bit. Now this could be a very easy place to screw up in this project because it's very critical that you drill with a drill press. If you use a hand drill to do this, chances are it's not going to be perfectly straight and it will lead to binding and very tight fits later on, so save yourself trouble and use a drill press. This is the base, and along the 14-inch line, I made a mark that is halfway across, and I measured up 2 inches from that line on either side and extended those marks. And on those lines, I marked 1 inch up from the end of this 14-inch side, and I'm going to drill a 1/4 inch hole at that intersection. Okay, now things are going to get slightly more complicated. I've got my hardware. This is just 1/4-20 carriage bolt, 2 inches long, and I want to run these through my holes. Next, I have this style of a protractor just to find an angle, and I just went ahead and set it to 60 degrees, and I want to align that with my fence, and this does not have to be critical. All this counts for is the minimum and maximum positions of these fences. Okay, now I'm going to set 60 degrees on the opposite side, and I'll mark a line for the other fence. Now I want to set my gauge to 90, and I suppose you just use a square to do this here too. And I'll make a mark at this fence, and for this one. Now this seems like it should be very complicated, but it's really not. All I'm going to do is take my hardware, run it through one of the holes, and then run it through the other hole in my template. I have a 1/4 inch router bit that has been fixed into my router, which is in the hole, offset 4 inches from the other side of my template. Now you can see we've created ourselves a little pivot point here, and what I'm going to do is, over the course of a few passes, route just maybe 1/8 to 1/4 inch past the lines that we drew with our angle. So the next step up is to install a 5/8 inch, or better yet, 3/4 inch straight bed into your router. Put that on the same exact template we used. You're going to have to enlarge the 1/4 inch hole that's 4 inches out from the end a little bit to fit the bigger straight bit. And then just put it on the same pivot point and route a very shallow dado just so that the head of the carriage bolt can be recessed into the piece of stock a little better. However, for some inexplicable reason, I forgot to film that shot. But I assure you, it probably looks something like this. So we have these two angled grooves all cut and routed out, but we also need to make a shallow 5/8 inch recess inside these two pivot points as well, because carriage bolts will get there too. Now I'm opting to use a 5/8 inch drill on my drill press rather than the router, because this one has sort of a funnel tip here, and I think it'll be a lot easier to center this within that 1/4 inch hole. I managed to cut down a piece of hardwood. This is ash, and it fits nice and tight in my miter slot. And there's absolutely no side-to-side movement in this at all. If there is wiggle room inside this piece of wood, what you can do is drill a hole that will fit a very small screw and cut a little slot and tighten a screw in there to pry the two halves apart a little bit. That way you can tighten it to fit exactly in this slot. Now, wood is prone to contraction and expansion, but I don't think it's going to expand or contract that much. And if it does, I can always come back and drill that hole. But for right now, we're going to roll with what we have. So I'm going to add some wood glue to this and glue it down. It's actually not critical that this be straight to the blade, but I want to do the best that I can. Looks good about there. For clamping pressure, I have 30 pounds of weight that I'm just going to let sit on top. So the very last step is to install the fences to the hardware. I use these knobs where the head of the bolt can go all the way through. Now to set the jig, there are these things that basically look like a triangle, and they each measure with a different angle, and you put them in between the two fences, and that will give you different combinations of segments per ring. These little triangles are a little bit overpriced in my opinion. You can easily draw an angle with a protractor, make the same exact thing and fine tune it until you get a good fit with your segments. Or I have a better solution, which is this. This is called a 30-60-90 art triangle. Artists use these for something, I don't know what. Basically, it is a right triangle, and this angle right here, the small one, is 30 degrees. And when I line this up between the two fences, that will give me a 12-segment ring. And the best part is, it's only $2. $2. You cannot beat that. Here's a ring that I made out of walnut. I think this one came out really well. I don't have any gaps at all. And I don't have to glue these up into pairs and sand each half to split the difference of the angle. I get a perfect circle right off the bat. If you enjoy this video, give it a like, give it a comment, and subscribe to my channel especially. And I will also link this video right here, which will drag you over to the most recent follow-up vlog type video on my second channel. Once you get there, give that a like, comment, and also subscribe to that channel. Tune back in next Friday for a brand new video on this channel, and I'll see you all then. Bye-bye.